Anthony F. Elmore, President and Founder of the Proud Black Buddhist World Association, here today to bring you in another exciting Black Buddhist lectures. We at the Proud Black Buddhist World Association are not only the Black Buddhist force in America, we are the Black Buddhist force in the world, and we are the only Black Buddhist organization in the world that do not have Asian Buddhist masters. When we learned that the Asians educated all Black history, culture, and language from the Buddhist teachings, we educated them out as our teachers. Now, today we're going to bring you an exciting Buddhist lecture. My lecture today is titled, The Beatles, Buddhism's Bodhisattvas. Most people, when they think of Buddhism, they think that Buddhism is some Asian on a mountain meditating. That is not the type of Buddhism that we practice. We practice only the highest teachings of the Buddha, and that is only the Lotus Sutra that explains that Buddhism is our everyday life. White people and Asians and Black people who are trained in Buddhism by white people in Buddhism, they get so excited when they see an Asian on a mountain meditating. We at the Proud Black Buddhist World Association are not excited at all about some Asian on a mountain meditating. We are excited about the Bodhisattva. You see, what is exciting to us are the actions of the Bodhisattva. See, a Bodhisattva is an ordinary person who take up a course in his or her life that moves in the direction of the Buddha. See, a Bodhisattva is kind of like being Christ-like. You see, the Beatles, coming up from Liverpool as young men, were influenced by Black American music. They were not brought up to hate and be racist. Now, prior to coming to America in 1964, they clearly put in their contract that they would not support the American racist system. You see, in 1964, they passed the Civil Rights Act of 1964, and that in America, we lived in Jim Crow. Now, the Beatles, when they came to America, they refused to play at segregated venues, hotels, or support racial segregation. In 1964, they had this sellout show at the Gator Bowl in Jacksonville, Florida. The concert was originally supposed to be segregated. The Beatles refused to play or perform until they received assurances from the promoter that the audience would be mixed. They had this sellout show of 32,000 and the Beatles refused to perform. Boy, they changed their tune. You see, John Lennon said, quote, "We never play to segregated audiences, and we aren't going to start now. I'd sooner lose money than lose out appearance money." Just a few years ago, Dr. Kitty Oliver was this young 13-year-old girl that came to see the Beatles in 1964, and she met Ringo Starr. And this little girl came backstage, and the Beatles, you know, hugged them and embraced them because the Beatles, they challenged racism in America. See, Black people get excited when they see a Buddhist priest. Many of them practice racial segregation. Many of the priests, they practice racial segregation. They don't say anything about what's going on in America with this police killing Black people. You see, in Nichiren Shoshu, they do not have Black priests. And they all, the SGI, Nichiren Shoshu, Nichiren Shu, and all these Buddhists, they all educate Black history, culture, and language from the Buddhist teachings. They may be Buddhists, but they are certainly not Bodhisattvas. It was because of the Black music, whereas we got the British invasion. It was in 1964, whereas President Johnson signed the Civil Rights Act of 1964. But
It was in 1964 when the British invasion came to America, when the Beatles came to America. Unlike Elvis Presley, who was America's greatest tool for segregation, it was the Beatles who came to America to join the civil rights movement. In fact, the Beatles refused to play at segregated audiences, stay at segregated hotels. Now, this is what Paul McCartney said at a Little Rock concert. Now, Paul McCartney introduced his song Blackbird by telling the audience, quote, "Way back in the 60s, there was a lot of trouble going on, civil rights, particularly in Little Rock. We would notice this on the news back in England. So it's really important place for us because to me, this is where civil rights started. We would see what was going on and sympathize with people going through those troubles. And it made me want to write a song. If it ever got back to the people going through those troubles, it might help them a little bit." Unquote.
Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night.
Fighting in the world for freedom, justice, and equality, we're the Red Suited. We're called the Proud Black Buddhists. We're going to put you guys on alert in the 15th chapter of Lotus Sutra, where the Bodhisattvas on the earth. Them jazz suckers who try to knock us. We are the Black Bodhisattvas. Dr. King, Malcolm X, and Nelson Mandela. The Black Bodhisattvas, the one that was stubborn and come from India. His name was Zachary Hill in Mecca. The old name for Indians in Eastern Ethiopia. From the land of India called Eastern Ethiopia, a great man called Shakyamuni Buddha. His great teacher was the Lotus Sutra.